McNeil here, International Headquarters, McNeil Film Studios. Today we will be discussing story number three, really, in the price taker discussion that we're having. And this is, in the long run, what happens. Now we have to remember that the long run is a period of time in which there is sufficient time for firms to enter or exit the industry. That takes time. So normally I set you up in a short-run situation and then let time roll and see what happens over time. And the conclusion to the story is that over time, in pure competition, if you're a firm in pure competition, that is a price taker, the economic profit will be?
Zero.
That's right. Because if there is profit, then there will be?
Entering of companies.
Entry, that's it. Good for you. And if there is a loss?
Companies will be exiting.
Exit! Wow. So, here's how it works. This, remember, price taker, the price to the price taker comes from the market. So here's the market. And the market says the price is pi here for profit. So if this is the price, boom, that becomes the marginal revenue equals demand equals price, P1, D1, MR1. Now, the firm will produce where MC equals MR, of course, and that will be the quantity. Now, Q1, and as we start up from Q1, up right there, look at that point. That's the average variable cost, and more importantly, this is the average cost of producing that quantity. And look, the price is greater than the average cost. Well, the formula for profit per unit is price minus average cost. So in this case, that number is positive. The firm is making a profit in the short run. Now, when we let time roll, if this is the typical firm making a profit, then when we let time roll, firms will enter, others will enter this industry seeking profits in excess of normal. And when entry occurs, the supply shifts to the right. When the supply shifts to the right, the price in the market goes down. So entry, supply up, price down, until what? Until the price goes down to where the price equals the average cost, the minimum point of average cost. When the price equals the minimum point of average cost here, there's no more incentive for firms to enter because there are no economic profits to be gained from doing it. So the entry stops, and this then is long-run equilibrium in a purely competitive industry where the price, P1 here, is equal to the minimum point of the typical firm's average cost curve, and generally speaking, firms are not making economic profits, only normal profits. What if there is loss? Well, there will be exit. And when firms, so this is a picture of loss here, if the price is P sub L here for loss, then this becomes the marginal revenue, sub L, it's the demand curve, sub L. And this is the quantity this firm would produce, Q sub L. And as we go back up, they cover all their variable costs, but their average cost is greater than the price that they're going to receive. So that's a loss. Now when loss occurs, what happens is some firms exit. And when they exit, the price goes, so the supply goes down, supply shifts to left. The price goes up until the losses disappear. And the losses disappear when the price is equal to the minimum point of average cost here. And the profits are zero. So in the long run, economic profit equals zero. Price will equal average cost. If there are profits, firms will enter. The supply goes up, the price goes down until it's equal to average cost. If there are losses, exit, supply shifts left, price goes up until price equals average cost. We see this all the time. It is a process that takes place in the long run. There are lots of examples of it. I would be happy to share that with you at some future time.